but this year's version, 1997, will long be remembered as the night that changes the course of history in professional wrestling. Well, because it will be tomorrow night in the nation's capital in Washington, D.C., where Sting and Hogan finally battle for supremacy in our sport. It is a battle between the two greatest stars in our sport. It is a battle between the two most influential, strongest organizations in our sport. And it is a battle to see who is on top of the heap in pro wrestling. And it all can be yours if you make that phone call tomorrow night, Dream.
Yeah, Tony, when you know, I was just listening to you run off all them things, and they are all so true. And when I think about careers that I have, and mine, of course, I had my day. And I think about careers of other great wrestlers and great athletes and great events, period, and Super Bowls. And I try to relate back to all these things. I have never seen an excitement around a pay-per-view or around an event or around a match. And you talked about the other matches. Now, give them their due. But this one confrontation, the bird of prey, the tradition, the line that came into the den of the king, as you call it. And then Hollywood Hulk Hogan, on the other hand, representing the New World Order. But I really believe it goes at this point of the next 24 hours or so, it's going to be what's inside Hollywood Hulk Hogan and how bad he wants to defeat him. And I've just got to be cautious, Tony. Don't underestimate Hollywood Hulk Hogan and his wrestling ability. You know what I'm talking about? I know he's going to have a lot of help, but his ability.
Dream, I don't think anyone can.
You can't beat Giant. You can't set attendance records. You can't hold major titles. You can't be a driving force in this industry if you don't have that ability. And he does, and I just want us to be ready. I'm talking to us, WCW, for this thing on
pay-per-view. I don't think anybody's going to take Hulk Hogan lightly because he is Hulk Hogan.
Yes.
I know he says he's Hollywood Hogan now.
Yeah, but
and I know he wears the black,
yeah,
and he looks a lot different than
Hulk Hogan,
than what he did when he wore the yellow and the red.
Right.
But it's still
good
Hulk
point.
Hogan.
Yeah. There you
it's
go.
Still
that's all I'm saying. And that's my worry. Even more that I'm not worried about the legendary Larry Zbysko pretzelizing Eric Bischoff. I mean, and Eric, you know, underestimate, got to have a game plan. This hand's faster than this hand. His feet are faster than his feet. You know, as he went through his soliloquy. The legendary Larry Zbysko will put you in the sugar and you will squeal like a pig. Serious, you know, that's just the way it is.
And we'll have a microphone there to hear him do that,
yeah,
as a matter of fact.
Yeah, yeah. But as we watch these luchadores, let me ask you this question. We've seen, and you might not be able to answer this, but this is on the tongues of every wrestling fan out there and non-wrestling fan that watches Nitro. When you say, let's bring out all my Nitro guys and let's give out some presents, what is keeping WCW from standing in the middle of the ring in another segment or whatever it is called in television land and saying, let's bring out everybody from WCW. Let's show our unity. We have not seen that to the extent I want to see it. That's why I'm fearful. I'm fearful of what could happen tomorrow night at Starcade.
I think WCW is going to have its day.
I do too. I believe
I know WCW is going to have its day.
But do you understand what I'm saying? A little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here's the thing to ponder. Why go out there? Why go out there Monday, 6 days before Starcade, and risk getting beaten? Getting pummeled by a group of guys.
Well, that's just one man's
wait,
thought.
Wait for the big event.
Yeah. Well,
I can tell you right now, if there was ever any determination, Ultimo Dragon,
kicking the bad feet,
series of rapid fire kicks. If there was ever any determination that Larry Zbysko needed, he got it Monday when he watched what happened.
Oh yeah. Now, I ain't worried about Larry.
Okay. If there was any determination that Diamond Dallas Page needed for winning the U.S. title over Curt Hennig, he got it on Monday.
I ain't worried about Dallas.
If there was any more determination that Sting needed, he got it on Monday.
I ain't worried. Well, I just answered my UN. Yeah, well,
everybody,
I did bring up a good point.
I tell you what happened. I tell you exactly what happened Monday night. They can chase off announcers.
Oh, yeah.
And they can make light of everybody.
Yeah.
And I tell you, let me tell you this. They can call me fat all they want, but it don't matter. They can beat me up. So what they're going to do, they're going to go home this year. Here's cover one, two.
I remember so many years when they would say, I can't believe that big old fat boy is the world's heavyweight champion.
Yeah.
Well, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
It don't matter. I am.
Rick Rude can come out and threaten me, and what's he going to do? He's going to go home and tell his wife, hey, honey, I beat up a fat 40-year-old announcer. Well, I'm a big man.
Are you 40 years old?
Well, I'm close, okay?
Oh, okay.
Nevertheless, what has to happen for the NWO is they got to prove themselves in the ring, which they haven't.
Okay.
They have not proved themselves one-on-one.
I knew I'd get you going off on this. Yeah.
Okay? So, end of story. Yeah. I tell you what they've done. They've sparked a fire within WCW that I don't think they can handle tomorrow night.
Yeah, just don't underestimate them.
I don't think they are men enough to handle what WCW is going to throw at them tomorrow night.
We will be there to find out.
And I'm going to say it to the 7-foot Kevin Nash. Yeah. He's not man enough to handle what the Giants going to do to him tomorrow night.
All right, going with it.
All right, well, here's a cover. Get my blood pressure up.
Brother, I got a 40-year-old man on the bed.
For being 30.
I've had a cardiac arrest right here on Saturday night. Is it exciting? That's good, though.
Well,
I'm just trying to draw it out of you. You know what I mean?
I know.
Why don't you talk a little bit?
I'm sorry.
No. That was great. No. You laid it all out.
Well, I tell you, I'm going to be honest with you. For being 35 years old, I get
pull
excited.
Pull my truck up. I'm out of here.
For being 35 years old.
Up on the top turnbuckle.
Oh, here we go. Back to the mat.
Man, I tell you, there's just areas that...
It's exciting.
There is an electricity and excitement in the air that we have never, ever felt in the sport.
Oh.
Great timing by the Ultimo Dragon. He kicked
you know, in the words of the immortal Males Lane, my main referee man, not to quote him, but I will, let's get it on. I mean, you know.
That's right.
I mean, it's here. Oh, man. Boy, look at this mess.
The Dragon Sleeper.
Yeah, well, you can go ahead and ring this one, too.
Yeah, I tell you, he was shaking the hand. He had nowhere to tap.
Nah.
And the Ultimo Dragon is your winner. This is our Ultra Strength Bengay replay here on WCW Saturday night. And it was a great win for a great athlete, Dream.
In auto fall, the Ultimo Dragon, to get to the Dragon Sleeper, he had to go through a series of quick, fast maneuvers. And I guarantee you, from his feet all the way to his lethal hand, we see a great athlete in Ultimo Dragon. Go ahead and take another look at it. When I talk about feet, there they are. One thing was understood and made for sure. Tony Schiavone is emotional, as everybody is, about Starrcade this week.